Check out this quick tutorial on using the Rotobrush feature when working with the Adobe Creative Cloud Suite of video editing software. The term rotoscope refers to a lengthy process of tracing around an object for each frame within a video segment. Fortunately, the Adobe Creative Suite of products makes this process easier. For this tutorial, here is a segment I downloaded using a free subscription at videoblocks.com. Drag a clip segment directly to the Adobe Premiere timeline. Premiere will automatically create a sequence along with the imported segment. Hold down the Alt key and left-click on the clip segment. While holding down the Alt key, drag the segment straight up and release the mouse button before letting go of the Alt key. This will create an exact duplicate of the clip segment onto the V2 track. Trim the segment on video 2 for an area you want to rotoscope. Right-click on the V2 segment and choose Replace with After Effects Composition. Give the project a name and save. Now you have an After Effects project linked to your clip segment within Adobe Premiere. Double-click on the segment layer within the After Effects timeline. In doing so, you will be able to use the Rotobrush tool on the segment layer. Click on the Rotobrush tool within the After Effects toolbar. To resize the brush, hold down the Command key and then hold down the left mouse button and drag straight up to resize the brush. Use the keyboard shortcut Command Plus to zoom into the composition window. Then hold down the space bar to maneuver within the zoomed area. Paint over an area using the green Rotobrush for an area you want to cut out. After Effects will make his best guess on selecting the area. Okay, the Roto for my skier looks fairly good, with the exception of a few areas. To remove unwanted areas from your Roto, hold down the Alt key and paint away the areas with the red brush. The green brush adds areas, and the red brush removes areas. In this example, it's going to be tricky to get the ski poles. Remember, you can zoom in and out of the composition using the Command plus and minus keys. After you have a basic roto for the first frame around your subject, press the space bar to let After Effects follow the rotoscope for the rest of the frames. The last step is to spot check each individual frame by using the keyboard shortcut Command Right Arrow to advance one frame at a time. Repeat this process until your roto looks good. After you've completed the roto, navigate to the lower right corner of the composition window and click on the Freeze button to lock in the rotoscope data. Then, navigate to the File menu and choose Save. In doing so, you can quit or minimize After Effects, and it will update your segment within the Adobe Premiere timeline. Within Premiere, turn off the eyeball for the V1 track, and you will see the cutout of your object on V2. Offset the V2 segment by dragging it to the right by a few frames. Navigate to the Effects palette and drag the Dip to White transition at the beginning of the segment on V2. Double-click on the transition effect within the segment, and give it a duration of 5 frames. Then go back to the Effects palette and drag a Dissolve for the ending transition. So let's check out what we have. To complete this effect, we can duplicate the clip segment we did earlier by holding down the Alt key and then dragging the segment straight up onto the V3 track and then releasing the mouse button to create another offset. The last step is to add some sound effects to the timeline. If you need great quality sound effects, you can download them with a free subscription to audioblocks.com. For other great tips like this, visit geniusdv.com and check into enrolling in a hands-on course.